Hello, Retro Fans. Today I have received a small package from the Czech Republic, and it includes two tiny devices, and it's going to be the Armsit. And you may be familiar with the original Sit, like the 6581, which looks like this, and then there's the newer version made by Commodore, that's the 8580, and there are several revisions like this. And then the thing with those chips is that the last production was run in 1989 or something like this, and therefore those chips are quite old now, and they kind of dying depending on your power supply, depending on heat, or simply because they are old. And then there were several attempts to create rebuilds or kind of replacement for those chip chips. And the thing is that they are pretty complicated. So the sound emulation of those chips, like you know this from emulators like Wise or CCS or even the new C64 Mini, it is really something that takes some time to get it right, because the SID comes with three voices, and those voices can be used for several waveforms, and that's all the easy thing. But the tricky thing is that there's a small analog part inside the SID chip, and this is the filter section, and this filter section is very hard to recreate as a digital thing, and it costs some kind of a CPU power to calculate the right behavior. And in the past we have seen the so-called Swinsit Nano, which looks mostly like this. There are several versions out of the on the market, and this was probably the first attempt to recreate a SID chip in terms of replacement with kind of an FPGA chip as a main thing, as a core, something like this. And then as a next step, we have seen the so-called Swinsit Ultimate, which is an advanced version compared to the Swinsit Nano. And I have covered this briefly in one of my videos, and I'm still short on testing this small device in depth with several programs and all that stuff. But in the meantime, I have received a new thing, and that's the so-called Armsit. And it looks like this. It's optical wise quite comparable to the SID chip replacements I have shown already. And then we will have a test whether this run will run in a C64 Reloaded MK1 board. And the first thing I recognized is that we will have an issue getting this thing onto the board, because it has very short pins. So I think the main challenge is going to be getting this thing connected to the board without losing it. And it looks like it's pretty tight, but it may work. So, and then we may have to configure the board as well. So there are a couple of jumpers on the board, and they say J6 close for 6581 and open for 8580, and I think we are safe to go for the 8580 version. Mostly those chips are able to reproduce either the 8580 or the 6581, and they can handle either 9V or 12V, and therefore you can use them on almost all of the boards available outside. And well, let's give it a try. Let's see whether this is going to boot up, and then we will have a first test run of this chip. I haven't used this board that much in the past, so I just populated it with a CPU and a PLA. That's a PLA replacement, that's not an original PLA. And most of the other components are stock, coming from individual computers like this. And well, I have attached my Pi 1541 I/O adapter version 2 with the display added. And there will be a link how I have built this one. And we're going to use this to load the configuration program as well as the update program. So now we got some basic screen. So let's have a check what's on the disk. I copied the programs for the ARM SID already to my SD card. And then we have two things here which look a little bit strange. And this is the update program. One is with a detection of the SID chip, and one is kind of a blind update program. This is very useful if you have a MK2 board, for example, or if you are using the SIDFX twin SID adapter, and the program won't find your ARM SID. So I think we are safe to go with the first one. Since we have just one on the board, and I think this should work fine. I'm not having a fast loader equipped, so take a couple of seconds to run to load the program. And since it's not a floppy disk image, we won't have any activity or floppy drive noise, but I hope it's still working. So the package is really nice. It comes in this ESD box, and this was wrapped in a bubble foil and in a normal plastic package. So that's really a nice shipment. And the program has been loaded, so let's see what happens if we're going to start this. ARM SID found, firmware version 2.4, emulated device 85 something, not in bootloader, continue. Okay, why not? Erasing app header, done, resetting. Continue, yes. So, it has done something. Firmware version is 165.3, so we made a huge step forward. that's indeed a little strange. So let's see what happens if we're going to try this again. Ah, now it's going to program something. And now we got firmware version 2.4. Okay, the next thing we're going to load is the configuration program that has been shipped with this ARM SID. Well, shipped is maybe the wrong term. I got this from the website. And it's going to be this one. It's a little bit smaller than the update program, so the loading should take not that much time. And in the meantime, I'm going to show you the web page for the ARM SID. So that you've got the URL as well. So So let's just run the program and see what happens. So, arms had found that address something, auto detector, press 6678 to auto, whatever auto means. Permanently save extended menu for restart the tester. Okay, let's have a look what the extended menu is. Okay. So we got different filter settings, that's very nice. And we got filter frequency, that's cool. So that's something to play with. And well, I think let's keep it to the 8580 for now and see whether we can load the program. And what I really missed to mention in terms of SID replacements is the FPGA SID. And that's a very small device. And I think this needs some attention as well. And it looks like this. So let me briefly switch over to this view. And it's a little bit bigger. It got some bigger ICs on here as well. But this one is able to emulate two SIDs at once. So if we're going to place this on this MK1 board, we have the ability to run two SIDs in parallel. So we can use either the old and the one and the new one, or we can use two times the same type of SID and run stereo SIDs and all that stuff with it. And that's very close to the final shipment now. So this is still a prototype, but the final version has been released quite recently. And I think the shipment will start somewhere end of October, beginning of November, just as a information as well. So, but now enough chatting. Let's see whether we can load program to listen to some music, because this is going to be the main purpose of this device. So we may go for something that comes with a turbo lader already, so that we don't have that much time to wait. And one that really sounds amazing is Slipstream for the C64. And let's go and load this one. So, let's see when the sound starts. Sorry for the initial sound, I had some configuration issues here, and now I think it's working better. sounds quite good, okay. Good for the moment. And well, in order to step into a game, you may require to be able to control the whole system by pressing fire and then just step into the game. Still a lot of loading, but now it's done. So I think as a first test this sounds really okay. Let's see whether we can start a demo to check whether the sound for a demo sound is as good as we expect this. So let's see how we can find a good demo that works out of the box and sounds good. I think this one is a good one. Please check that your emulator is using SID8580 and press yes to continue. That's interesting. I've never seen this message on a C64. So it looks like the demo has detected that we are not using a normal SID chip. And since we have configured it to be an 8580, I think we are fine to say yes. And now let's see how this thing is going to sound. Thank you. So I think we are not going to watch the whole demo. I just let it run a little bit in the background. And the interesting thing about this demo is that it uses a lot of filter effects as well and has some very deep drums, and I think as a first impression this sounds really amazing. I really have to spend more time with this amazing new device, with this new replacement for this old SID chip. And usually I do this in comparison with a normal SID chip, so I'm running this on an MK2 board or on a SIDFX or on a Mixit, so that I can compare the two channels directly, and then you can hear the differences quite clearly. So every time the sound sounds like a stereo, then there is a difference, and then you may spot what's going to be the variance in the replacement or in the emulation. So anyway, that's all for now. That's really just a brief and short impression of the ARMSID, and I'm still short with presenting you the webpage where you can find this amazing device. So let me just switch over to my laptop view, and then I can show you the page I'm talking about. So this is going to be this one. So it's a little bit cryptic, as dzi.n.cz, and then you can find this webpage, or you simply Google for ARMSID and then you will end up here, and you will have a lot of interesting infos about this device, and you can find the firmware as well as the program, how to configure this whole thing, and there are even two threads in the Forum 64 as well as on Lemon 64 about this nice device. And if you're interested in to get this, then just drop Bohemil an email and stating that you want to get one, and then you will probably put on a wish list or something like this, on a waiting list, and as soon as this device is going to be available again, you get an information. So basically that's all about the ARMSID. So I hope you had some interesting time, and you learned something about this amazing new device. And as usual, if you have any questions or comments, feel free to use the comment section. And if you want to stay informed about further tests of SID replacements and all that stuff, then feel free to use the comment section as well, and subscribe to my channel. It's absolutely for free, and then you stay informed about further updates, and then I can include this in the next videos as well. So thank you very much for watching, have a nice day, and see you for the next video. Bye bye.